Hey everyone, and welcome to video 7 in the series in which we examine the lifecycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. In this video, we're going to be writing tests for the piggy bank coin that we wrote in videos 1 through 6. If you haven't seen those videos, I would recommend going back and giving them a watch before you watch this one. In the last video, we wrote some driver code in Python for our piggy bank puzzle. Now we get to perhaps the most important part of this entire process, which is testing. Since these coins are going onto a blockchain with no central authority, it is very important for you to thoroughly test them for bugs before you launch a coin like our piggy bank, because you can never get it back. It will be on the chain forever, and it has the potential to be bricked and made unspendable, or to potentially allow a user to have their money stolen. Neither of those is good news. Because of the risks, it's a good idea to write tests that cover the entire lifecycle of a coin, from its creation through every possible state that it could be in, and every possible attack that someone may attempt. As you can see in front of me, I have a testing suite that covers this for the piggy bank coin. Rather than write this in real time, I'm simply going to walk you through it because this testing library could be a whole video series on its own. Again, in this series, we're mostly just concerned with the lifecycle of a Chialisp application and not so much the nitty-gritty details of the Python implementation. Before we go through the test, let me go ahead and show you how you can initialize your own test, because a lot of this surrounding code may look pretty complicated. If you go ahead and go to CDV test here, we can look at the help and we can see that it has two flags, init and discover. We're going to go ahead and run init now so we can see what it does. As you can see, it created a test directory in our project and it brought in a skeleton test. This basically is the bare bones infrastructure that you need to run a test on your coins. This is going to import our testing library, which you can find in CDV test. And it's going to yield us a couple of objects here. It's going to yield us a network object, which is basically a stand-in full node. It's going to yield us an Alice and a Bob wallet, basically so that we can send money back and forth between these two individuals. You would write all of the test stuff here where it says pass, but again, this is just a skeleton project. So let me go ahead and show you what my actual lifecycle tests look like. If I go ahead and take this piggy bank puzzle and move it into tests, if we run CDV test discover, we can now see a list of all of our tests that we have yet to run. So I've got three tests here. Let's go ahead and break them down now. All right, so you can see here that I am importing our drivers that we made in the last video. We have create piggy bank puzzle, solution for piggy bank, and piggy bank announcement assertion. I'm also importing a couple of objects that I'm going to need here. This is, again, very specific to Python, and if you are interested in writing this in Python, I would recommend that you go check out the Chia blockchain repository and familiarize yourself with where some of these objects are. We have our basic setup stuff from our test skeleton, and then I have a helper function here that is going to basically do the entire spend process of our piggy bank for each of our tests. It's called make and spend piggy bank, and it's going to take all of the stuff that our setup yields to us, and it's also going to take a contribution amount. This is the main variable in testing our piggy bank coin, right? We are either going to contribute a certain amount and we're not going to reach the savings goal, we are either going to contribute and then reach the savings goal, or someone is going to try to contribute and try to take money from our piggy bank. Those are the three scenarios that I want to test. To run through this pretty quickly, basically we have the network farm a block for our Alice wallet, and then we launch the piggy bank coin using this launch smart coin function. This function takes a puzzle, so that gives us an opportunity to use our very first piece of driver code, which is create piggy bank puzzle. We're going to set the savings goal to this for 1 Chia, and we're going to use Bob's puzzle hash as the cash out puzzle hash. That's just going to make it a little bit easier to check that when we do reach our savings goal that it actually cashes out properly. This is going to return us the coin that it has created and that we are now going to be spending. It's going to return us basically our piggy bank. Next, we need to find a coin that we are going to use to contribute. Basically, the wallet has a method called chooseCoin where it just finds a coin that has at least the contribution amount, which will be different based on test to test. So we've got our piggy bank and the coin that we're going to use to contribute to it. Now we need to make both of the spends. Here, we're going to make the piggy bank spend first. We're going to call this spendCoin method, and it takes the coin that we want to spend, and I'm setting push TX to false because I don't want this to immediately push the transaction to the network. I'm saying just return us the spend because we're going to be aggregating this with the other spend, so I want to make sure this doesn't automatically make it to the network. Finally, we're passing it args, which in this case is the same thing as solution, And we're using our second piece of driver code, solution for piggy bank. And we're passing it our piggy bank coin that we have made, as well as the contribution amount. If you remember the driver video, that is how we defined our driver. So it's going to go ahead and handle all of that for us and return to us a program that we can use as a solution. For our contribution spend here, we are again calling spend coin. We're specifying the contribution coin. We're telling it not to push the coin to the network automatically. And we're specifying the amount that we're going to be spending. Here's why. So the amount that we're spending here is the amount of the coin minus the contribution amount. Basically, what we're doing here is we're sending a transaction to ourselves, but we're sending it with a less value than what we started with. This is like sending the change to ourselves from the contribution. What we're doing is, since we have a higher value to start with and a lower value to end with, we're creating extra value in the spend, and the piggy bank is going to absorb that extra value as a contribution. I have to specify the conditions that I want to come out of this puzzle, and so I'm going to specify that we're going to create a coin right back to the exact same puzzle hash, right back to ourselves from our right hand to our left hand, you might say. And then we're specifying the amount that we want to create, and it's going to be, again, the total amount of the coin minus the contribution amount. That's how much extra value we want to create in the spend. Finally, we need one more condition in order to link this to the piggy bank coin so that the piggy bank coin doesn't get excluded and this transaction pushed through, because that would result in extra fees for the farmer and no actual contribution for our piggy bank. So we're doing piggy bank announcement assertion, and we're passing it the same arguments as we pass solution for piggy bank. This is going to return to us a announcement condition that we can use to assert that the piggy bank coin is being spent at the same time as our contribution. Finally, we're going to take both of these spends. We're going to aggregate them into a single spend bundle using the spend bundle.aggregate method. And it's going to take both of the coin spends from each of the spend bundles. It's going to turn them into one list, and it's going to use BLS to aggregate each of the individual signatures from the individual spend bundles into one single aggregate signature. Now that we have our combined spend bundle, we're going to go ahead and push this to the network, and we're going to return the result that we get. Now, in most scenarios, we want this result to not have an error, but there are a couple of scenarios where we would want it to have an error. So let me go through the tests right now. This was just the helper code that's going to run the actual life cycle of the coin for us. But now let's use the specific tests to make sure that we test every possible scenario. The first scenario that we're testing is the piggy bank contribution. This is the scenario in which we contribute to our piggy bank, but we have not yet reached our spending goal. We're going to go ahead and call this function, but we're going to contribute 500 mojos only. After we do that, it should return us the result of pushing to the network, and we're going to make sure there was no error in it. This spend should be valid and should have gone through. And then we're going to be using this filter mechanism here to make sure that we have a coin that is 501 mojos. When we launched our piggy bank coin, it got launched with a 1 mojo value, so by contributing 500 mojos, the piggy bank should now have 501 mojos in it. And we're making sure that this 501 mojo coin has the exact same puzzle as the piggy bank puzzle that we have calculated via our driver code. We make sure that we have exactly one of these coins, and if so, we pass. Perfect. Let's go on to our second test here. Test piggy bank completion. This is the scenario in which we reach our savings goal. We want to make sure that when we reach our savings goal, not only does the piggy bank recreate itself with a value of 0, but also that our cash out puzzle hash gets paid. So we're going to go ahead and call this with 1 trillion mojos, or 1 chia. This should go through. We're going to make sure there is no error in the result, and then we're going to use this filter mechanism a couple more times to make sure that there is a coin with amount 0 and a puzzle hash that is the piggy bank coin again. So we want to make sure that our piggy bank with amount 0 exists after we've reached our savings goal. Finally, we're going to make sure that Bob actually got paid. So we're making sure there's a coin with 1 trillion and 1 mojos in it, and that coin's puzzle hash is Bob's puzzle hash, because that is the person that was supposed to be paid when we did this. Finally, we are going to be testing whether or not we can actually steal from this piggy bank coin. Remember, we only want people to be able to contribute if they are adding money to it. If they're trying to subtract money from it, that should fail. This is a much simpler test. We run the same exact helper code, make and spend piggy bank, but this time we're going to pass it a contribution amount of negative 100. We're trying to withdraw some money. We're going to assert that there is an error in the result, and that the error is generator runtime error, which means that it tried to run this puzzle, but the puzzle raised at some point. This is what we want. We want to make sure that our puzzle is enforcing these rules and not any of the surrounding code. We want to make sure that it is very specifically the CLVM that is failing, because the surrounding code can change, but the CLVM is the only thing that's committed to on the blockchain. If both of these are true, we pass and we should be good to go. Let me go ahead and show you an example of running these tests. If you type CDV test, it will automatically look in your tests folder and it will run all of the tests in here. And as you can see, it also passed our skeleton test, which is kind of funny. But as you can see, all three tests passed. We have 4 passed in 5.5 seconds. And that's it. That's the entire life cycle test of our coin. Remember, it's very important that you go through and you think about every possible state that your coin can end up in. You want to have a test case for each of those scenarios, because if for some reason in the future you ever need to change the puzzles, you want to make sure that no attacks have opened up and that all of your functionality is still working. That's going to be it for this video. In the next video, we're actually going to take this coin and we're going to get it onto a blockchain. If you have any questions, go ahead and head over to our Chialisp channel on Keybase. We're usually pretty available over there, so we'll be happy to help you out. Until then, I will see you in the next video.